Did you know that on a daily basis, aliens and predators are battling here on Earth? Some of these battles happen so far away, we have no idea they are happening. Welcome to the Kimberley region of Western Australia, one of the last pure wilderness and one of the most harsh but beautiful landscapes in this massive continent. Here, over the last 4 years, I have been studying a very unique interaction between an invasive alien and a native predator. The invader is a plant. Stinking passion flower, or Passiflora foedita, is native to South America and it's now invading this landscape. Now, passion flower has a tendency to grow close to water, so it loves growing up in these banks of the mighty rivers. The predator of our story is the endemic Australian freshwater crocodile, his kind. Now, freshies also use these banks as nesting habitat. And that's where the conflict happens. When the weed overtops the nests, it changes the temperature regime inside the nest, which in turn affects the sex ratio and the embryo survivorship. In crocodiles, the sex of the babies are determined by temperature, not through genetics like in you and me. And if the nests get too cold, the embryos stop developing. So we have been using a range of tools and techniques to study this unique interaction. From above, using chopper surveys, we study how nesting happens at a landscape level. Using photogrammetry, multispectral and LiDAR drones, we study how the weed change its spread and biomass over time. On land, we have data loggers recording temperature every hour in the nest over the incubation period, and remotely triggered cameras looking at the behavior of crocodiles within the nesting sites. At nighttime, we do spotlight surveys, catch all the baby crocodiles, and study how the recruitment levels change over time. So, two take-home messages. A, the indirect impacts of invasive species can sometimes be more devastating. This study highlights the importance of also studying those interactions. B, the same invasive species can have completely different interactions and impacts based on the landscape. So, when you want to control and manage invasive species, that needs to be done at a context-dependent or a location-specific level. I'm Richard Somavira. Follow more of my work on my website or my social media.